evening and welcome to the Spring Choir and Orchestra Concert. My name is Wendy Reynolds.
Thank you.
And it's my pleasure and privilege to serve as director of your college choir. And we could not offer this concert without our marvelous pianist, who you'll meet in a moment, Justine Aldridge. And she also plays cello in the college orchestra, led by my colleague, Dr. Joseph Van Riper, orchestra director and chairman of the music department. So you're in for a really fun treat tonight. We have a lovely lineup for you, followed by a reception in the lobby. Please join us afterwards so we can say hi. A friendly reminder to please silence any and all beeping noisemakers. Now, a bit about what makes our choir unique. Did you know that we are a community choir, which means anyone in our community who wants to sing with us is invited to? Like, not right this minute, but you can join audit, you can take it for credit, you can be part of the choir any semester that you're interested in, and we'd love to have you. You don't have to be a trained singer, by the way. That's a truly community choir. So, also, we're really excited because we recently discovered that we have 7 countries represented in our choir here tonight, in addition to the United States, right? So we have Kenya, the DR of Congo, Latvia, Russia, Germany, England, and Peru. Now we can clap. Yeah, we need to. And as our group grows with international members, we are going to be giving you more and more international music every semester. So we're really excited about that. Yes. This evening's choir program is comprised of a spirited combination of popular and inspired inspirational tunes. We'll begin with a wonderful arrangement of Bill Withers' Lean on Me, paired with gospel song We Shall Overcome. With all we have already overcome in our community and in our world, and the challenges which we continue to face individually and collectively, it's important to remember that we can lean on one another for support, and that we will indeed overcome the storms near and far. The next selections remind us where our love and fortitude come from. In Thee, O Spirit, a familiar hymn from the Christian Science hymnal, followed by Craig Courtney's beautiful anthem of gratitude, Simple Praise, and then Mary Baker Eddy's communion hymn, again from the Christian Science hymnal, arranged for our choir. Some of you may recall our final selection, which is from 1989. Let the River Run was written by rock star Carly Simon for the film soundtrack of Working Girl. The movie stars Hollywood greats Melanie Griffin, Sigourney Weaver, Joan Cusack, and Olympia Dukakis, a true powerhouse of women starring in this, along with a few supporting men we should probably acknowledge, like the unknowns Harrison Ford, Kevin Spacey, Alec Baldwin. So Carly Simon won an Oscar and a Golden Globe for this song, and we'll be presenting a fabulous arrangement by choral great Kirby Shaw. So now, without further ado, enjoy the music.
Thank you.
Thank you all, and good evening. Welcome to the McVeigh Center for the Performing Arts at Maury. This is your, I think this is actually the first time we've ever had a full orchestra on the Robert Duvall stage here. So we're super thrilled to have this happen. We were all ready when COVID hit, and we had everything sort of came to a screeching halt. And as you know, we were all had to wear masks, and so we couldn't have any winds or brass players while we were in that COVID era. So when the mask mandate lifted, we were so excited to start bringing our full orchestra back together, and it's I think we're in a really good place. So thank you for being here. This next piece is a Slavonic march, also called March Slav. This is by Peter Tchaikovsky, who is a Russian composer who grew up under a great deal of political turmoil. He composed this march in response to a war between Serbia and Turkey. So in this piece, you'll hear a collection of Serbian folk songs and a rousing rendition of Long Live the Tsar. So it was meant to unite the Slavic peoples during a challenging time. So this is Tchaikovsky's March Slav.
Thank you.
This next piece you'll see on your program is the iconic Radetzky March. Now, if you're from Vienna, you'll be very, very familiar with this. And perhaps, as I understand it from the students, this was actually rather popular on some TikTok recently. So I know that you may know at least like 20 seconds of it. So you may be like, ah, that's the one. This is the one. But this was a piece that was composed back in 1848 by a man named Johann Strauss. And Johann Strauss is actually really well known for being the waltz king. He composed several beautiful waltzes. And so it's kind of ironic that the waltz king is also really well known for this great Viennese march. This brings us back to the Austrian Empire in the mid-1840s. And there was this great big battle to try and preserve the Austrian Empire. And they were actually able to preserve it, which was great. There was a wonderful victory, and the man behind the victory was a field marshal named Joseph Radetzky. Now Joseph Radetzky was a deeply respected officer in the military, but he was 81 years old in this battle. So this was actually really an interesting battle. So they came back to Vienna for this great big celebration, and in honor of Radetzky, Strauss composed the Radetzky March. And there's this tradition, if you've ever been to Vienna or any part of Western Europe, whenever they play this, specifically in Vienna, and usually around the New Year, the audience participates. The audience participates with applause. Maybe not with yelps, but with applause. So there's as the orchestra plays, the audience will clap. And there's a reason behind that. There's a neat story behind that. When they brought out this 81-year-old Field Marshal Radetzky to be honored with this new march that was commissioned by Johann Strauss, the soldiers were so overcome with joy and reverence for their leader, they couldn't stop clapping. And then, you know, that's not a normal thing in a symphonic concert. Those of you that may have been to rock concerts, that's a normal thing. But it's not normal in a classical concert to have that type of applause. And so it actually became a tradition, starting in 1848. Every time they played this in Vienna, to honor Radetzky, they would clap to the beat. The audience would clap to the beat. It's such a joyous occasion. So we get to do this together, and so yeah, that's exciting. But in a moment. And so this is the next best part. You'll see in your program that we're going to be honoring our dear president, another leader, and this is President John Williams. Well, come on down, John, who took over. Ah, come on down. And our First Lady, Missy Williams. Now, John Williams took over as the helm of the presidency of Principia College during a very challenging time in our school's history and our college's history, and was immediately thrown into the throes of COVID. Hang on one second. We're going to give you a better introduction here. So with that, we were just so grateful. I mean, to be such a sensitive and challenging time, to have a steady-handed leader who's taking care of our dear school, of our community, of our students, of our faculty, of staff. And we couldn't have been more happy to have President Williams and Missy taking care of us. So you are like our Radetzky. And so that's why we wanted to honor you as the guest conductor for this. And we have a walk-up song for you.
Luckily, the introduction was longer than the piece.
Thank you. President.
Thank you.
Marvelous. Thank you so much.
Thank you, John, and thank you, Missy. We're going to finish tonight's program. Can't top that, so really should have put that last, sorry. Poor programming on our part. But before we play our final piece for tonight's program, we have some special people to thank. I mean, first and foremost, I'd like to, there's so many people. But we'll start up with Media Services. They've lit us up, they've recorded us, they've done such an outstanding job broadcasting us. If you're out there on YouTube, feel free to clap. There's a bunch of several dozen people listening on YouTube. Thank you so much, Media Services. Bravo. Alex and Stephanie and Eric and the whole crew, Toms, thank you all so much. I'd like to thank Jill Geis, our department office manager. Jill and Mark together, what an outstanding team. Thank you. The Geis family keeps us all going. Our programs and helping with logistics and everything. I'd like to thank our colleagues, not only my colleagues in the music department, but our colleagues outside of the department that have been so supportive, especially Dr. Sarah Andrews, who comes during the school day, taking her lunch hour, to play with the orchestra. We're so grateful for music department. Dr. Andrews, thank you all so very much. And last but not least, I'd like to thank our seniors. We have several seniors who are playing their last concert here at Principia, and it's really difficult. It's really difficult as a faculty member to grow with these students and watch them grow for 4 years, and then to grow with them and to share all these experiences. And some of these students I'd see 4 days a week for 4 years in a row, and it's really, really difficult to say goodbye to these wonderful students. We'll start with Victoire and Richie, I think our graduating seniors in the second violin section. Thank you, Richie, Victoire, and Emily, our oboists, who finally could rejoin us because we're out of COVID. And we're so grateful, Emily. We also have, oh my goodness, we're our departing postgraduate teaching intern, Ben. Thank you, Ben, for your beautiful service. And then we have Gail Pine on the cello. We lost her last semester to an abroad. We'd like to thank those seniors so very much. Thank you so much. Bravo. And the last three, yes, let's clap. That's, you know, it's funny, just backstage, I was talking to Sophie before she walked out. I said, I remember when I first met you on Arts on Tour in Virginia. We did a performance in Washington, D.C., and she came up and said, I play the violin. In fact, she was playing a similar Bartok piece that we were performing, and it felt like yesterday. I mean, it really felt like just last week that we met. And then I remember meeting George for the first time, George Ghanem. I remember meeting Katie and having her show up with a viola case. I remember seeing the case and saying, oh, is that a viola? And it was like everything came together. They started a string quartet. The students themselves, they took that initiative. It was so special. And these last 4 years have been really great. And I'm sorry. It's been, thank you, seniors. You know, I feel like it comes in waves. You get to this point where people graduate and you say, that's it, I'm gonna leave too. And then something else good happens. But, you know, I'm excited. I'm grateful to have been a part, to have been able to be a part of your college experience. And thank you for your service to our orchestra seniors. And I can't wait to see what's next for each of you. The last tune is Brahms' First Symphony. And it's personally my favorite, one of my favorite symphony movements, the fourth movement. And Brahms was quoted telling, told his friend, I shall never write a symphony. And he said, you have no idea how the likes of us, talking about composers, feel when we hear the tramp of a giant like him behind us. And of course, he's referring to Ludwig von Beethoven, who composed 9 brilliant symphonies, and Brahms was right on the tail end of that. And so, I mean, talk about setting the bar high. It was very challenging for Brahms, or anyone for that matter, to want to compose a symphony. So it took Brahms 20 years to compose a symphony, this first symphony. And the the melody that you're going to hear at the very beginning, this first theme, is just one of the most touching melodies I've ever heard in my life. I first played it in a youth orchestra, and I remember sitting there going, I don't know what this is, but this is something I think I want to do for the rest of my life. And so this is one of the things that brought me into music more seriously. And I mean, I don't know if I'm allowed to dedicate this, but I'd like to dedicate this to our seniors, because I feel like this just touches the heart, and they've just touched my heart in so many wonderful ways. And so this is the fourth movement of Brahms Symphony 1. Thank you.
Thank you.
tuned. We have many other events coming up, a couple Caroline concerts, a Sophie recital, a Hannah recital, all sorts of good music. So stay tuned, and we'll see you next week. Thank you all.